Looking for the best telescope for viewing planets and galaxies? In this video, we'll break down the top telescopes available whilst comparing them for price versus performance. Before we get started with our video detailing the best telescopes for viewing planets and galaxies on the market, we have included links in the description for each product mentioned, so make sure you check those out to see which one is in your budget range. Starting off at number 1, we have the SkyWatcher 10-inch Dobsonian. The first telescope that I'm going to talk about is the SkyWatcher Dobsonian. If you ask the majority of astronomers what's the best for seeing galaxies and you're not willing to shell out thousands, then they'll say the same thing: get a high aperture Dob. The SkyWatcher is a good example of exactly what you can get if you're looking in the mid-range ballpark of prices. It is a step up in class on cheaper scopes for a few reasons. It's got a 10-inch aperture. This is 254mm. This is significantly more than other telescopes that you'll find, and you'll definitely notice the difference between this one and other telescopes that are available. The large aperture, allowing more light to come through, will undoubtedly end up with you getting a better view from your telescope. It also has a 1200mm focal length, which makes for some great magnified views. What some people particularly like about the Dobsonian is that it's very easy to collapse it down and store it. One of the biggest issues people face with high-quality telescopes is that it's very difficult to store them for later. Fortunately, this isn't an issue with the SkyWatcher, as it's easily collapsible and you can store it away for later. Overall, this is one of my favorite options for a good quality telescope that will give you some awesome views. Yes, it's a little more expensive than some other options that are listed, but it's definitely worth the money if you have it. Some people will argue about it having go-to tracking, but that isn't necessary for Dobsonian scopes as they are very easy to point and use. I'm going to talk about some other types of telescopes in this list, but I would advise you to stick with the Dobsonian if you're looking for anything more in depth. $500 or $600 on a reflector is not going to give you enough aperture to see galaxies as well as a Dob. Fact. At number 2, we have the Celestron NexStar series. Next on the list is the Celestron NexStar series. Here, you're paying a similar price to the SkyWatcher, but you're getting 6 inches of aperture instead of 10 inches. If you want more, you're going to up your budget significantly. I have to mention a computerized scope in here because for some people, they may be better. Personally, I would always stick to a manual scope because, well, the hunt is part of the fun. But computerized scopes have their benefits too, and the NexStar is a solid option. The Celestron NexStar is a good option for you to look at if you want to get a quality telescope. The series run from the 4SE up to the 8SE, with the cheapest of those starting around $500 and running all the way up to in excess of $1,000. You don't need to get the best model, though it will ensure that you're going to get a good quality image. The 6-inch aperture is ideal for seeing objects that are really far in the distance, like the Orion Nebula, which is one of the best things to start with if you're a beginner. You'll be able to get some really good images of different planets as well. This isn't solely because of the aperture, but it's definitely a contributing factor on how good the telescope is. It has a 1500mm focal length, which is another reason why you're going to get high-quality images at extremely long-range distances. Bear in mind that this will also make the scope length a little longer too. Many people think that computerized telescopes aren't really for beginners, but this isn't the case. This telescope is extremely easy to use, so you won't have any trouble using it to the best of its ability. If you don't mind having a telescope that stays in one place, it's 30 pounds so it's not the most portable, then you could consider a telescope from the NexStar series. At number 3, we have the Orion 9827 AstroView. The Orion AstroView is a pretty good option for anyone looking for a solid telescope that gives a nice quality of image. It has an increased aperture from the cheaper telescopes I've talked about. With lower quality telescopes like the Celestron PowerSeeker, you're getting a 127mm aperture, but with the AstroView, you'll get a 150mm aperture. This increase in aperture proves a little better for seeing the sky, especially when you're looking for galaxies, as you'll definitely need this increased aperture. Though in an ideal world, you'll want an 8+-inch Dobsonian. Another thing that you're going to want to take into account when you're considering the AstroView is that it has a 750mm focal length. This is important for those who are looking for things at a greater distance, as the focal length will have a bigger effect when you're looking at highly magnified images. I particularly like the AstroView because of the two eyepieces that it comes with that seem to be of a decent quality. They're very easy to use, and they give you a good way to get a 30x and 75x magnified view quickly. All in all, the AstroView is one of the better telescopes on the market, especially for newbies. It's very easy to set up too, which isn't typical for telescopes of its nature. At number 4, we have the Celestron AstroFi 102. Another option that you could go for when considering a telescope to purchase is the AstroFi 102. It's another telescope from Celestron, who are undoubtedly the most popular telescope brand. The main issue that I can see easily with the AstroFi is that it has a pretty low aperture. This is especially true if you compare it with other telescopes that I've listed, so it's worth considering this if you've been looking at the AstroFi. But having used this telescope myself, it does a good job for seeing close-up sky objects. It comes with two Kellner eyepieces, which help to create a good image without being particularly expensive either. The main reason that people are attracted to the AstroFi is that it is easily integrated with your Wi-Fi and your phone. This means that you can easily use it with your iPhone or your iPad. You can actually install an app and use your device to control the telescope. While this might sound like a gimmick, it's actually a pretty cool feature. Overall, this is another safe option if you want to see planets clearly, easily. Bear in mind that you will need to make sure the sky is clear to get a good view of the sky, but this is true with pretty much any telescope. And for our final pick at number 5, we have the Celestron PowerSeeker 127 EQ. The last telescope on this list is the PowerSeeker 127. This isn't the most powerful telescope that you'll find, but it is a good example of what you're going to get for a cheaper price. There are other better telescopes if you're looking for budget telescopes to use with the kids. You know that when you buy a Celestron, you're making an investment, so you don't have to worry about it breaking too much, as they have good warranties. Their support team and warranty are relatively good in my experience. The aperture of the PowerSeeker is 127mm. This seems to be the agreed aperture that you'll need if you want to start taking your astronomy a little more seriously and start seeing more than just the moon and faint planets. It also has a focal length of 1000mm, which is another important factor to consider if you're purchasing a new telescope. If you want a good budget option, then the PowerSeeker is an acceptable choice. But in reality, it's actually not the best of its kind, and there are better telescopes you can consider that are relatively cheap too. So that sums up our top telescopes for viewing planets and galaxies of 2019. We hope you enjoyed. If you did, please leave a like on the video. And if you're new here, hit that subscribe button. Until next time, have a great day.